Hey, so we're looking at the Dark Valley, and I just knocked all my bits. That was smart, wasn't it? All right, we're going to run through all the combats. The very beginning of the game starts with a combat, then a move situation for the Germans, and so we're going to go from north to south. North being Army Group North, Army Group Center, Army Group South. To your right of screen, and we'll just run through all these combats, and we'll see how it all works and see if I get it right or if it's fun. I'll be back to you in just a minute. I'm going to pause.
So the first combat we're actually going to do is this little guy right here. I've got six factors here, and it's a straight up 6-1. This is clear terrain, even though there's a little piece of woods in there. That is clear terrain, I believe. Let me just check the terrain chart. Yeah, it would be, that would look to be the case. We have no bombardment, nothing else going on there. It's a straight 6-1. In the clear, actually, that motorized unit, if it was stacked with a tank mechanized unit, we would receive a bonus. We would double the combat factors. And turns 1 to 3, the German motorized units double their combat factors on defense in clear terrain and double their attack strength if stacked with at least one panzer unit in clear terrain. Alright, so, regardless, it's 6-1. And we roll a 5. I don't know if you can see that or not. Probably not, because I'm zoomed in. There it is, it's 5. And that's going to boom, that's going to be a defender eliminated. Yep, DE. So that guy's toast. We'll pop him over there. We get to advance into that hex with all of some of the units. Alright, we're back. I'm just pausing this as we go through. I actually wanted to attack this hex, not that hex, so we just moved these guys into here. Left these ones behind in the port hex to protect them. And we now have a whole bunch to one attack here, which is also in the clear. So we'll roll a die, and we rolled a 2. And you can't see that because I'm zoomed in. Let me zoom out just a little bit. And a 2 on a 6-1 is a defender retreat with an asterisk. That's a chicken. Defender retreats as above, and if defender has 2 or more steps, defender loses a step if blah, 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 yada, yada, yada. Soviet attacker must take a step loss as well. So, attack loss. Okay, attacker takes a loss. Defender retreats 2 hexes. So, this guy retreats 2. We want to clear that row, so that's goodness. And he has a little chart that tells us which way he has to retreat. See that? Okay, so we're going to go 1-2 to here. Actually, we might go here. In the open. Death in the open, but regardless, we're going to do that. I've got this little panzer division there. So I said it was a whole bunch to one because that panzer... Oh, that's an interesting point. I'm not see, those factors would have all been doubled there. 10 and 4. I would have been 14-1, but it's 6-1 is the highest. Would have liked to have seen. I'm curious why there isn't a, an automatic victory mechanic in this when you're so overwhelmingly strong there. Anyway, it's clearly that would have been more than a defender retreat, perhaps. Who knows? Okay, I'm not sure if that supply thingy advances or not, so we'll come back to that in a little bit, and we'll now move to the next attack in a second.